If you're a big swim team and you like to order a lot of gear, maybe you ought to check out Swim Outlet Team Division for these reasons. Swim teams receive a 10% discount on bulk orders. Swim teams or organizations get an 8% commission on referred sales. You'll also like their customization services, which is affordable and available at all times during the year for all team gear. With over 50,000 items in stock, you can get most anything you want. Swim Outlet Team Division. You need to try it out. You'll be glad you did.
This is the Morning Swim Show for Wednesday, December 5th, 2012. I'm your host, Jeff Cummings. Bruce Gemmell has been at Nation's Capital Swim Club for a couple of months now, working with such young talents as Katie Ledecky. I spoke with Gemmell at the USA Swimming Winter Nationals last week about a number of topics, including making the transition to the large swim club.
All right, so Bruce, thanks for joining us. You're kind of getting into your new job there at Nation's Capital. You heard USA Swimming Nationals 2 months after you took the job. Let's start with what got you started with them. Tell us the process of you getting hired there.
Well, I've known the staff, known a couple of coaches there for quite a while, and maybe the end of October or the end of September, early October, they gave me a call and said they might have an opportunity, and if they did have an opportunity, might I be interested? And having a lot of respect for the program and the coaches there, I said, sure, I could be interested, and that they left it at that. They didn't give me any more details, and obviously looking back, that's when they know Yuri had an opportunity to go out to Cal. So maybe 5 to 7 days later, they gave me another call back and said that they could tell me that Yuri was leaving, and was I still interested? And knowing what I knew about the program, of course I was interested. And we moved very quickly from there. I want to say it was 3 to 5 days before I was down there and on the pool deck, and Yuri was out on the West Coast. So it moved quickly once it happened.
Well, and it was actually pretty easy. I'm sure your Delaware is not that far from Washington, D.C., so it's not like you had to make a big move.
Right, right. I've actually been commuting a lot back and forth while we get the family moved and everything. So, yeah, I could get on the pool deck. Actually, I was there for Yuri's last day, and the next day I was running the show. So it was a pretty easy transition.
Was that a kind of tradition that you're okay with? Because I mean, most coaches want to take the time to get to know swimmers and all that, but you, like I said, had to get right into it.
Well, you know, it would have been nice to start out a season and have been able to do some season planning and schedule meets and schedules and dry land and things like that, but that's not the situation we were handed. And you know, the kids were very open. You know, Yuri was terrific, the other coaches were terrific, the parents were great. So all things considered, it was about as smooth a transition as you could expect.
And of course, there are a lot of great swimmers there at Nation's Capital. Of course, you're now taking over coaching Katie Ledecky. I'm sure that had to be a big draw for you.
Yeah, Katie's there, and the beauty of the group that specifically that I'm working with is they're very young. There's not a single high school senior in the group, a few juniors, and the rest of their senior group at the site are all sophomores. So, you know, it's a three-year program that I can put together at least with the group that I walked into.
Yeah, so you're not, you know, taking a person and all of a sudden seeing them go off to college.
Right, right, right. So that helped make it attractive in itself.
Now, Nation's Capital isn't just one pool. They've got like 9 pools all over the D.C., Virginia area. How much contact are you in with the other coaches on the team?
Well, as I mentioned, a couple of the coaches I've known for a number of years, so they've been very helpful and talk to them pretty regularly. And then you have a tendency to work closely with the ones that are geographically closer to you. For instance, Tim Kelly's down at American University, and we actually join groups some days and work together and obviously speak more frequently. But all of them have been tremendously welcoming and very helpful.
What's it been like working with Katie these past couple of months?
Oh, Katie's awesome. I had a chance to get to know her a little bit at the Olympic training camp this summer in Knoxville, and she was all game face there, and that was good. That was appropriate there. But getting to work with her in a little bit more day-to-day environment, you know, she's obviously a hard worker, but she's, you know, a member of the group, wants to be a member of the group, and they all work together real well.
Yeah. Let's go back to your early days as a coach. We'll start off, actually, you were a swimmer. You grew up in Delaware. went to school at the University of Michigan, swam for Jon Urbanchek, and then I think you told me earlier it's kind of an interesting story about how he kind of wanted you to get away from coaching, even though it was something you wanted to do.
Yeah, with all respect for Jon, and I will say that he was one of the people that I talked to about taking the job that I took. He was very supportive of it and encouraging. I was going to grad school and coaching alongside Jon and finishing up my master's degree in engineering, and it occurred to me that I really wanted to go into coaching. And I went to Jon one day and said, Jon, I think I want to be a swim coach. And he started yelling and screaming at me, no, you don't want to be a coach. The hours are long, the pay is lousy, you're going to hate it, look at me. And of course, I also found out later that Jon had flunked out of engineering school. So maybe that was part of his response there. So with the respect I had for Jon, I sort of said, yes, sir, and went and got an engineering job for about 8 or 10 years.
And then you just kind of, I guess, the light bulb came.
Well, you know, I stayed in touch with swimming a little bit, but my son was born, and of course I had to take him for swim lessons. And when I took him for swim lessons, the club coach there, who I had known from before, said, hey, would you want to help out with the age group team? And once I helped out with the age group team, you know, sort of the die was cast, and you know, 10 years later or 15 years later, engineering was long gone, and it's probably the best decision I ever made.
Yeah, maybe the pay is not as good, but you know, it's a sport you love.
That's okay. I'm doing what I love, and you know, every day the greatest day? Maybe not, but there are many, many days that are really good days to be on the pool deck.
And we're talking to you on the day or the last day of the U.S. Nationals. You just watched one of your swimmers, Megan Burns, do really well. So this is one of those days.
Yeah. Megan Burns actually trains at one of our other sites, but you know, she's great. I guess she's only 14 years old, and she's cranking up that mile today, and that's just makes it fun to watch. We've got other great swims tonight.
And so basically you were talking about your son was born and that got you into coaching, your son being Andrew Gemmell, who made the Olympic team in the 1500. Talk about the experience of coaching him. You know, there are a lot of swimmers who have been coached by their parents growing up, and coaching him to now being an Olympian.
You know, it was certainly one of the most frustrating experiences of my life sometimes, but at the end of the day it was by far the most rewarding. He gets all the credit in the world. You know, I couldn't have done it if he wasn't receptive to the idea. And you know, we had our ups and downs. We sort of put a little later in his career, we sort of put a moratorium on discussing his swims until about 10 or 15 minutes after he had swum, because both of us have a lot of energy after his swim. So we'll talk about it later. And in some ways it works better now when he's off at Georgia and I can talk about his swim and I don't have a vested interest in it.
Yeah, it's probably better for you now. You can watch as a parent, yeah. As a coach.
Yeah.
But I'm sure when you're watching him swim, like maybe at the Olympics, you're like, come on. That coaching brain never turns off.
Yeah, well, he came home last summer before the Olympic trials, and he was with me for the several weeks leading up to the trials in Omaha, and so I felt like I was his coach then, and I played that role pretty well, I think, until maybe the last couple hundred meters at trials, and then I think the parent role just took over a little bit.
That's bound to happen.
Yeah.
It's bound to happen. Well, let's go back to coaching at Nation's Capital. You got any kind of five-year plan for yourself or the team?
Well, you know, I'm just learning about some of the ins and outs of the team. Certainly there are so many good coaches there, not only the senior level, but at the age group level. And, you know, if we can channel that energy into the right places with the people doing the things that they love to do, like I do. You know, some people love working with 10 and under, some people like working with distance people, some people like working with sprinters. And, you know, we get everybody in the right spot, and the coach and staff will all work together. I know it was one of Yuri's goals before he left, really, to bring the team back to national prominence, where, you know, was before at one point, and it might have drifted off a little bit, but where we have multiple swimmers. I call it in the USA Swimming Pipeline, you know, going to national select camps, junior teams, national teams, and then obviously top of the pyramid of the international travel teams.
Right, and of course you're going from a relatively smaller team with Delaware Swim Team to now this bigger team. Does that feel overwhelming to have a kind of a bigger squad to work with?
Not really. There's about 150 swimmers at the site I have, and you know, we operate pretty autonomously when we want to or need to. And you know, when we have problems or run into issues, or when there's, you know, synergy we can work together, we do. But I'll be able to do a lot of the same things I did before and help and develop the swimmers from, you know, those early age group years to where they're, you know, prominent at the national level, I hope.
It's something I've kind of seen that Kurlberg, which is the name of Nation's Capital before, and now especially with Katie Ledecky, is always a great distance program there. You know, you go back to even the Tom Dolan days and whatnot, and, you know, you having a great distance swimming background and coaching Andrew through distance swimming in open water. What keeps the team so well-rounded with the distance swimming when, you know, there's always such this big focus on the exposure, you know, the bigger exposures with sprinting?
Yeah, you know, maybe I haven't been there long enough to understand that completely. Certainly there are parts of our program, you know, that develop swimmers other than, you know, the distance program. I think that, you know, being as big as they are, maybe they can channel a little bit more energy to a distance program or where there can be a distance focus, where I think a lot of the programs, you know, there's so much energy on the shorter sprinters that sometimes the longer sprinters, as I like to call them, might get, you know, sort of ignored a little bit.
Yeah. Well, I think you're probably feeling really happy there. It's one of those probably dream jobs every coach would love to have, and here you are, you've got it.
Yeah, it's a great job, and ask my wife, I'm happy when I'm on the pool deck, so when I can spend time on the pool deck, whether it's here at Nationals or back at the home pool with some of the younger ones, that's my happy place, not the engineering office, maybe, as we just talked about.
Yeah.
Sorry, John.
That's okay, I'm sure John is even happy you kind of chose to.
Yeah. I stay in touch with John a lot.
That's good. Bruce, thanks so much
for
joining us.
All right, thank you, Jeff.
Pleasure to see you back on deck.
Thank you very much.
Our thanks to Chris, and our thanks to you for joining us for today's Morning Swim Show. Be sure to follow us on swimmingworld.com, on Facebook, and on Twitter for the latest swimming news. I'm Jeff Cummings. We'll see you next time. Our thanks to Bruce for taking the time out of his busy schedule in Austin. Bruce is back on deck this weekend at the Tom Dolan Invitational hosted by Nation's Capital Swim Club. Swimming World will be there streaming the meet live on the internet, and we hope you'll join us to watch what could be a very fast meet. That's going to do it for today's Morning Swim Show. I'm Jeff Cummings. Thanks for watching.